Welcome to 60 Second Civics, the daily podcast of the Center for Civic Education. I'm Mark Gage. Each of the 13 American colonies had some features of representative democracy that we still see today. For example, each of the colonies had a legislative, executive, and judicial branch. Colonial legislatures held a great deal of power, but were elected only by a small group of people, white male property owners. Women, indentured servants, Native Americans, and enslaved people were typically not allowed to vote. The King of England would appoint a governor in some colonies. In others, such as Maryland, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, the governors were the proprietors of the colonies. Only in Connecticut and Rhode Island were the governors elected. The courts administered justice in the colonies, and judges followed strict rules of procedure. The American colonists also understood that they had the rights of Englishmen, which were the common law rights that people also enjoyed in England. The colonists were protected by the rule of law. The legislatures, governors, and the courts were charged with ensuring that government proceed in accordance with both written laws and long-established customs and traditions. Finally, as we've mentioned, the colonies featured representative government in the form of representative assemblies elected by at least some of the people. However, in order to vote for either the upper or lower house of the legislature, men had to own a certain amount of property. That's all for today's podcast, 60 Second Civics, where civic education only takes a minute.